One of the health features that's had a big update in iOS 16 is the sleep tracking feature. It will now give you a lot more details about your quality and duration of sleep. Here's how it works. So to begin, we need to make sure we've enabled our watch to do sleep monitoring. So on the Apple Watch app, scroll down till you get to sleep and make sure this setting is turned on. Of course, you're going to need to wear your Apple Watch to bed for this to work. But don't worry, because it will go into nighttime mode, so you won't get notifications and your screen won't come on. In fact, if you've got an alarm set, your watch will gently buzz on your wrist rather than making a noise to wake up the whole room. Now, all that's left to do is have a nice cup of hot chocolate and go to sleep. Oh, morning time. Okay, let's jump back into our phone and find out just how well we slept. So I'm going to go into the Health app this time, and at the bottom I'm going to go to Browse. From here, scroll down until you find Sleep, and then straight away you'll get this colourful graph showing your last night's sleep. Just like everything in the Health app, you can scroll sideways to view different days, but the interesting thing here is rather than just showing you time in bed and time asleep like it used to be on iOS 15, we now get different stages of sleep as well. We'll have a look at what those mean in a moment. But as I scroll down the page, you're going to get more information about how well you slept and how your vital signs changed over the course of the night. So for example, your respiratory rate, your heart rate as you were sleeping, those sort of things. Okay, let's go back up to the top and we're going to click on to show all data. From here, we can see the exact amount of time, both in percentage and minutes, that we spent in the different stages of sleep, whether that be awake or REM sleep or core sleep or deep sleep. You can also look at your duration, and you can make comparisons between the time you were asleep and what your heart rate was doing at the same time. Now, sleep tracking is nothing new on the Apple Watch and in the Health app, but the amount of detail you get now is quite different to what you had before. If I switch into weekly view and then scroll back a few weeks to before when I installed iOS 16 and watchOS 9, you'll see I get this turquoise blue bar. It just shows you if you're asleep or if you're awake, and to be honest, it was never that accurate. Now, as I scroll forwards, you'll see this much more rich, colourful data picture showing up. And with this information, I can now see just how many times those annoying cats have woken me up during the night. I can also look at this data on my Apple Watch too. So on the watch itself, go into the Sleep app. As you scroll up and down this page, you'll get more information, just like you would do on the phone, and then you'll get that nice colourful graph, but it's much more convenient sometimes having that with you on the watch. And that's a quick look at the new sleep tracking feature in iOS 16.